Hey, Chandler Bolt here, and in this video, I want to talk to you about how to eat and structure your diet for maximum energy levels. This might be the most boring but also useful video that you've watched in a really long time, and I know that there's probably two groups of people watching this video. Group number one, you really care about the food that you eat, and so you're probably obsessed about this already. And then group number two, this is not a topic that you care that much about or that you like. So my goal is for the people who are obsessed about it, I'm gonna give you some practical tools that you can use. And then if you're someone who doesn't really care or think this doesn't matter, hopefully by the end of this video, I'll convince you that it matters at least a little bit, and I'll show you one or two meaningful changes that you can make in your life around the diet and around the food that you eat to increase your energy levels. Now, I remember when I was growing up, a friend, a mentor of mine, he said, Chandler, I eat for fuel, not for pleasure. Now, I thought this was like the craziest thing that I'd ever heard. And he ate the same exact thing every single day. Now, I'm not advocating that you do that, but I think that, you know, really looking back years later, there was a lot of truth to what he taught me, and that's that the food that you eat has a huge impact on your energy levels. Now, this shows up in a lot of different places in life, and there's kind of a lot of ways that I've learned and things that I'm gonna pull in here for practical next steps for you personally. So one of the first times I experienced this, I did something called the Whole30, which is basically just this extreme paleo diet where, I mean, it's easier to list the things that you can eat than it is to list the things that you can't eat, because there's not a lot of things that you can eat. But what I realized at the end of that is that I'm actually pretty sensitive to gluten, to dairy, and to alcohol. Now, this is a big thing that I think a lot of Americans are sleeping on and don't realize, and that's that the majority of Americans have an intolerance to, or at least are affected negatively by, gluten and dairy. And I'll kind of caveat that, and that's American gluten and American dairy. And what so many people don't realize is that when you eat those two things, they negatively impact your energy levels. And also for me personally, I realized that I was having, you know, maybe a beer at the end of the workday. That was affecting my energy level, and that was affecting how well I woke up the next day. So what I want to kind of break down here is if you're kind of switching that mindset to going from, okay, I'm going food as pleasure to, yes, food sometimes as pleasure, other times as fuel, how can you practically implement some things that are gonna help you eat in a way that's gonna give you more energy? So I've already given you the first tip, and that's to cut out gluten and dairy and at least test it for 2 to 4 weeks and see if it makes a difference. Number two is to really watch what you eat in the morning. Now, I always say that your body is kind of like a computer. Now, a computer, if you know anything about computers, you know that it has RAM. Right, so RAM basically says this is how fast this computer can go, and you have different operating systems. Now, depending on whether you're browsing the web or watching a video or playing a game, there's different operating systems that are taking up the RAM or the capacity on that computer. So what a lot of people don't realize is that as a body, we have different operating systems. One of the biggest operating systems is your digestive system. So anytime you eat any food, your body says, all right, I'm gonna allocate 30, 40, 50, 60% of the energy that I have to digest that food. So now all of a sudden, I'm not able to operate at peak capacity. I have less energy. Or for example, if I'm sick, this is why a lot of times when you're sick, you're not hungry, because that's your body's way of saying, hey, let's not eat, because I need all the energy that I can use to fight this sickness, right? So you've got kind of these different operating systems, and as you can probably tell, I'm by no means a doctor or in biology or any of those things, but I do know enough to know that you have all these operating systems. You're thinking, you have your digestive system, you have, you know, things that are fighting sickness, stuff like that. So anytime you eat, and especially in the morning, just know that you're choosing to spend a lot of the energy that you have digesting that food. So one thing that I do is I'll not eat a lot in the morning. So I'll only have 2 eggs every single morning, and I also do bulletproof coffee. So bulletproof coffee is coffee with non-salted grass-fed butter as well as coconut oil in there. And now that has calories. It also feeds my brain. It helps me be alert, stuff like that. I've got another video on how I have ADD and how that's really a superpower, and Adderall versus bulletproof coffee and all that stuff. I'd encourage you to watch that video. But I do bulletproof coffee every single morning, and that helps kind of curb my appetite. That and then 2 eggs right before I start my day. And then, and this is really important, I do a salad in the middle of the day. So I'm not doing this heavy thick meal that's, you know, that's got meat in it, or that's got dairy in it, or gluten, or any of those things is kind of really wind my body down, I'm doing just the bare minimum. So that's the second thing, is watch what you're eating in the morning. And a lot of people go even so far as they do intermittent fasting, which this means that they don't eat until a certain time every day, and they eat all of their meals maybe between 2, 3, 4 and that night, right? So there's only a small window where they can eat. And I've found that sometimes when I do this, I actually have more energy. So that's the second thing, is not eating heavy meals in the morning or at lunch. And then the third thing is just to be mindful of when do you need a lot of energy, and how can you kind of plan your eating around that. Now, there's two very big things for me that I need energy to do. Number one is speaking. So I travel across the country, I'm speaking, helping people write and publish their first book. I've got a video on that that's kind of like my speaker promo. It's kind of cool if you want to check that out. But I travel all around the country giving these talks. Now, for me personally, I try not to eat before I give a talk. Or if I am eating something, it'll be a protein bar, or it'll be a smoothie, it'll be water, coffee, that sort of thing. So sometimes there's diminishing returns. Like if I'm giving a talk at 4 p.m., then I'm gonna have to have a smoothie or something. And then I'm gonna make sure that I just plan that accordingly, because you certainly need food to have energy. But I try not to eat before I give a talk. And then there's a day like today where I'm recording videos like this. I'll do 15 or 20 more videos. I need to be alert, I need to be high energy all day. So because of that, I've only had a smoothie this morning and I just had a protein bar, right? I'm not having this big meal in the middle of the day, and I'm not having this big meal and then recording more videos. And if I am having a meal and then recording more videos or then giving a talk, what I'm doing is I'm taking a nap. Now, I've got another video that talks about kind of how to take naps and why I think you should take naps every day. This is extremely important. And if you want to be mindful of your energy levels on a day-to-day basis, this is something that you need to keep an eye on. So those are really the three things that I recommend if you're looking to be more intentional with your eating, okay? So cut out gluten, dairy if you can. Watch how much and if you're eating in the morning. And then third thing, be mindful of when do I need to have high energy levels, and then plan and be intentional around the eating that you do around that. So I'd love to hear your takeaways from this. I know I'm always interested in trying new things, whether it's, you know, paleo stuff, whether it's Whole 30, whether it's just, there's all kinds of things that you can do to optimize this. Some work, some don't. I'd love to hear your experience. What worked for you? And probably more importantly, what was your biggest takeaway from this video? Comment below, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. See ya.